Hey, what's up YouTube? Welcome back to Cooking with Gerald. Today we're making sweet potato pie. Start off with 3 pounds. This recipe that I have calls for 3 pounds of sweet potatoes. I don't like to boil my sweet potatoes because I find that they become very stringy and for the most part somewhat flavorless. So I like to either bake or roast my sweet potatoes. Today I'm going to roast them. What I normally do is wash them, and then you want to poke holes in them so that they don't burst in the oven. You can use a fork or a knife like I'm using. You don't have to go that deep. You're just pretty much puncturing the potato. All right. And then also, what I like to do to my potatoes before I put them in the oven is cover them in oil, like rub oil on them. What this does is it actually makes the skin come off a lot easier once they come out of the oven. I don't wait for my sweet potatoes to cool when I'm making my filling. I actually make it the filling with the potatoes straight out of the oven. To me, it blends better. It makes a more smoother pie. So that's what I like to do. So what I'm basically doing is just rubbing them down. Just like this. Not a big, thick, heavy coat. Just enough to coat them. And then I preheat my oven to 400 and roast these for approximately an hour. You can check around 45 minutes. For these, they may go 45, 50 minutes because they're not as large. Usually when I do find the sweet potatoes, especially around this time of the year, they are fairly large. However, with these, I was able to find these all consistently the same size. So we'll go ahead and roast the potatoes and we'll be back. All right, guys, so it's been about 50 minutes that I've actually roasted the potatoes in a convection oven. Probably like about an hour if you have a regular oven. The potatoes are done. I'm able to stick a knife in them and they go in real easy. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna peel the potatoes, put them in my mixing bowl. I'm using a wire whisk attachment. You're gonna need about a half teaspoon of lemon extract, 1 tablespoon of vanilla extract, 1/2 cup sugar, 1 cup of brown sugar, 1 stick of unsalted butter, 1 cup of evaporated milk, 3 eggs, 1.5 teaspoons of nutmeg. I like to use ground nutmeg, where I actually grind mine myself with the microplane. This actually is a lot fresher and tastes a lot more pungent than nutmeg that's already been ground. And then also 3/4 teaspoon of cinnamon and 2 unbaked 9-inch pastry shells. All right, so I'll go ahead and peel the potatoes. All right, so we're back. This is actually a fairly quick recipe. Doesn't take much time. Like I said, I like to roast my potatoes, sweet potatoes, with the skin on them versus boiling them. When you roast them, you get the natural sweetness of the sweet potato. Their natural sugars come out. What I did is I actually peeled them, put them in a bowl, mixing bowl with a wire whisk, and I make mine up while they're hot. Adding the butter in, the stick of butter. What this will do when I'm mixing this up, it'll actually melt the butter. So we'll let that combine. Using a wire whisk, if there are some strings, once the batter is all mixed up, you'll be able to get the strings out because the strings will appear on the actual whisk itself. So I'm gonna go ahead and whip this up. Get it nice and fluffy and the butter melted. I find that when I do the mixture with room temperature or cold potatoes, that everything just doesn't mix and gel well together. So I guess if you could melt the butter instead of using a regular stick of cold butter like I just did, you can actually melt the butter and pour it in to the potatoes if you're mixing it cold. Okay, so now that we've gotten that mixed up, the butter in there, we're gonna add the white sugar and the brown sugar. Let those mix. Stir this around a little bit. Make sure it's catching everything at the bottom. All right. So the next thing I'm going to add is the evaporated milk. What I do with the eggs, I always add the eggs last because I always like to check the batter for flavor to make sure that, you know, that I have the right flavoring in it before I actually will add the eggs. With this recipe though, it's pretty much spot on, so you really don't have to do that, but I like to check it anyway just to make sure. So now I'm going to add the vanilla flavoring and then the half teaspoon of lemon flavoring. I like adding the lemon flavoring because it gives it like a little brightness that kind of wakes up the potato. It just does something to the pie. It just kind of wakes it up a little bit more. Next thing I'm going to do is add in the nutmeg. As you can see, I've actually grated the nutmeg. That's a teaspoon and a half. And then 3/4 of a teaspoon of cinnamon. Some people prefer a lot of cinnamon in their sweet potato pies. I don't. I grew up with more of a nutmeg, but more nutmeg in the pie. I guess if people are used to eating pumpkin pie, which has a lot of cinnamon in it, I don't particularly care for a lot of cinnamon in my pie. So I don't put it in there. Make sure I get all this off the sides and get it incorporated. I'll go ahead and let this beat up for a good 2 to 3 minutes on high just to get it smooth. We'll be right back. I'm back. I did let the mixer beat for about 3 to 4 minutes just to make it more creamy and not to get all the lumps, which there really wasn't any lumps in there. And also did check for strings. There really was none in there. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go ahead and add the three eggs that are beaten, three beaten eggs, and we'll be finished. Before I did add the eggs, I did check the batter for taste, and it was actually really good. Very, very good. The batter is done. As you can see, it's nice and smooth. No lumps or anything in this. It actually bakes very, very well. All right, guys, so I'm back. So what I'm gonna do now, like I said before, is put the pie filling in the pie shell and then bake it. You're gonna bake it for 15 minutes on 375 and then turn the heat down to 350 and bake it for another 45 minutes. 45 minutes or so, you'll be able to tell what's going to happen is it'll probably rise up kind of like a cake, and it'll be a little jiggly. Take it out. Once it cools down, it'll settle back down, and you'll be good to go. I did go back in and adjust the recipe. I let the batter sit for in the refrigerator for like about an hour or so, and tasted it again. I ended up adding a half cup more brown sugar. So that's a total of 2 cups of brown sugar and a half a cup of white sugar. And I added another teaspoon of vanilla flavoring, vanilla extract. So that's a total of 3 teaspoons. So I'll go ahead and pour the pie in the shell. And these are deep dish pie shells. So this recipe we'll make either two deep dish or probably 3 regular pie shells. All right, so like I said, this is gonna go in the oven on 375 for 15 minutes and then turn the stove down to 350 or the oven down to 350 and bake it for another 30 minutes or so. All right, guys, so like I was saying before, what I do is I make my batter up and I actually freeze my batter. Get a freezer bag, and usually what I'll do is I'll weigh my batter. First, I weigh my empty bowl, mixing bowl, because I have 2 mixing bowls. I weigh 1 empty, so I know how much it weighs. And then zero it out, meaning once the bowl is on the scale, I'll make sure that it is at 0, so it's not showing any weight for the actual bowl. Take the batter, look at how much pour the batter in the bowl. Let me start back over. Put the empty bowl, weigh the bowl, zero it out. And then what I'll do is I'll take the batter from the other bowl and pour it in that bowl. And it'll tell me exactly how much the actual batter weighs. And just cut that in half. And that's how I either make the pie or I'll store it. So what I do is I put it in a bag like this. Let all the air out. Lay it on it. Seal it up. But this one turns green. And then what I do is I'll go ahead and flatten it out like this. So that it's all even. Then I'll put it on. A baking sheet. And sometimes I just put it in the freezer on the rack as it is. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on the baking sheet until it gets semi-frozen. Then I'll straighten it out a little bit more. It'll be a lot more solid, so I don't have to put it back in the pan. I'll be able to put it on the rack and let it finish freezing by itself. But this is how I do, because a lot of times I'll ship my parents sweet potato pie filling. So all my mom has to do is open it up. Well, once it thaws, open it up, put it in the pie shell and bake it. So we'll be back after the pie has finished cooking. All right, everybody. So the pie just came out of the oven. I cooked it for 15 minutes on 375 and then 45 minutes on 350. And as I was saying before, I baked it. You'll notice that it's kind of risen up a little bit. As it cools down, it'll all settle and it'll be flat. So this is the pie. Once it actually does settle down, I'm going to take another picture of it to bring it back to you guys. Alright guys, so the pie has settled down and still in the process of cooling, and this is it, sweet potato pie. I'd like to thank you all for watching. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. Please share some comments in regards to if you tried this recipe, or what recipe you've tried, or what difference as far as the way that you make yours versus the way I make mine. Please share this video with anybody, everybody, all your friends, family. And if you'd like to be notified each time that I do post a new video, click the notification bell, and each time I do an upload, you guys will be able to be notified. Thanks for watching. Be safe, be blessed, and I'll see you next time.